Good morning to all. Today we are going to discuss two concepts. One is black box testing and second one is model based testing. Among these two, first we are going to discuss black box testing. Black box testing is also called behavioral testing, and this black box testing mainly focuses on the functional requirements of the software. So we already discussed white box testing. In testing concepts, this black box testing and white box testing are more important. So already we discussed white box testing is an internal view testing. That means what are the internal components of the program or software are involved to test all those concepts are possible by using white box testing. And the second one, black box testing, it's used for external view of testing. That means what are the inputs we are giving, for that what are the outputs are generating, and what are the functionalities are there to check the outside environment of the software or program, we are using black box testing. So such a black box testing is also called as behavioral testing. And this black box testing or a behavioral testing focuses on the functional requirements of the software. So what the software functionalities are there, how it is functioning, whether it is all the functionings are performing in a right manner or not, whether we are providing the right input and it generate right output and all the functionalities are working properly or not for the software what we design, to testing all these functional requirements of the software, we are using black box testing, and it is also called behavioral testing. With the help of this black box testing, we can attempt to find errors in the following categories. So we can find five different types of errors by using black box testing. In that, first one is incorrect or missing functions. We can find out incorrect errors or missing functions. Second one, interface errors. If there is any interface errors, already we discussed in the fourth unit what is meant by an interface. It's nothing but it helps to interact with our software. So such an interface development, it may contain any errors. To find out that one, we can use black box testing. And the third one is errors in data structures or external database access. So is there any data structure error? We can find out those errors by using black box testing. And is there any database access, external database access errors are there? To find out those errors, we can use black box testing. And fourth one is behavioral or performance errors. If there is any behavioral or performance errors, we can find out those errors by using black box testing. And the fifth one is initialization and termination errors. Initialization errors, nothing but giving input to the program and any assumptions are giving to the program, those initialization errors. And termination errors, that means output generation, report generation, such type of terminational errors are there. So initialization and termination errors we can find out by using black box testing. So simply, a black box testing means nothing but a behavior, is also called behavioral testing, and it mainly focuses on the functional requirements of the software. And these are the five different errors we can find out by using black box testing. And one of the important concept in black box testing is graph based testing method. So the first step in black box testing is to understand the objects that are modeled in software and the relationships that connect those objects. So the most important step in black box testing is to understanding what are the objects are used in the software and how they are related with other objects. Those relationships and what are the objects are there, want to understand, is the first concept and first step in black box testing. To understand those objectives and their connections in the software, we are using one of the most important concept in black box testing is graph based testing method. In graph based testing method, how those objects and relations are representing means given a pictorial format here. For example, in our program, we have three objects, object 1, object 2, object 3. Those three objects, how they are related, what are the relationship existing between these three objects, to know all these things or explaining all these concepts are nothing but the graph-based method. In black box testing, for example, here the relationship existing, it will be shown with the help of links. So here links are three different types of links are existed between the objects, direct links, indirect links, parallel links. For example, direct linked means, so here object 1 is direct, having a direct link to object 2. That means object 1 is related to object 2. That means the relationship is exist between object 1 and object 2, and object 1 is related to object 2, not object 2 is related to object 1. So it is a direction from object 1 to object 2. So such type of relation will be called, or such type of link are called as directed link. Then second link is a undirected link. There is no any arrow marks here. So this represent these two objects are related to each other. So one is related to three, and three is related to one. So bidirectional relation is existed between these two objects, and between these two objects only one direction from object 1 to object 2. There is no any direction from object 2 to object 1. So this is unidirection or directed link. And we have another concept link called parallel link. That means between object 2 and object 3, there are number of different relationships are exist. If there is different relationships are there between any two objects, those relationships may be indicated by using parallel links, double lines, no arrows and no single line, double line must be there. These types of two line format will be called as parallel links. These links represent different number of relationship existing between the two objects. So this is the total representation of graph based method, and this is the concept called graph based testing method, the most important concept in black box testing, to understand the objects and the relationship existing between those objects. And with the help of those graph format may be used in number of behavioral testing methods also. That's nothing but number of behavioral testing method that can make use of graphs. That means we have number of behavioral testing method. In those methods also we are using graph based methods, nothing but graphs. So a graph means nothing but we have two things only there. One is nodes and links. So how these nodes and links concept of graph are used in different behavioral testing method. So here we are given four different types of behavioral testing methods. And that first one is transaction flow modeling, second one finite state modeling, and third one data flow modeling, and fourth one timing modeling. So here these are the four different types of behavioral testing methods. In these methods, how graphs may be used. Graph means just two points we want to consider here. One is nodes and links. How we are using those nodes and links in these different models, we are going to see now. Then transaction flow testing, the first one. So what is meant by transactional flow modeling? How graphs are used here means, just come to the point. The nodes represent steps in some transactions. For example, we know what is meant by transaction. For example, take an example. If you are using a bank to deposit some amount, so user depositing some amount into the bank, it is one transaction, it is depositing. Then if you come to the withdrawal concept, bank giving the money to the user, it is another transaction. So that transactions is represented here as steps, and these steps represented in graphs as nodes. The nodes represent steps in some transactions, and the links represent the logical connection between the steps. So in transactional flow modeling also, we have two points. One is steps and links. So in graphs also, we have two concepts, nodes and links. So nodes here representing as steps and links representing as logical connections. So in the transactional flow modeling, the nodes represent steps in some transactions and the links represents the logical connection between steps. So this is the concept of transaction flow modeling. Then come to the second one, finite state modeling. How the nodes and links are represented in finite state modeling, you will see here. So in finite state modeling, the nodes represent different user observable states of the software and the links represent the transitions that occur to move from one state to another state. The state diagram can be used to assist in creating graphs of this type. So in the finite state modeling is used to represent how the objects are moving from one state to another state. To represent that one, we are using finite state modeling. In the finite state modeling also, how these graphs are used. So graphs means nothing but we must consider two things. One is nodes and links. How these nodes are representing and how these links are representing in finite state, it will be explained here. The nodes represent different user observable states. So in finite state, meaning states are represented as nodes, and the links represents the transition. Transition means moving or converting, changing, that transition that occurred to move from one state to another state. So the transition, the links are represented as transitions, and the user observable states are represented as nodes. So in this manner, in finite state modeling also, we are using graph methods. So the nodes are represented different user observable states of the software, and the links represent the transitions that occur to move from one state to another state. So the state diagram can be used to assist in creating the graphs of these types. So in this manner, the graphs may be used in finite state models also. Then come to the third one, data flow modeling. Data flow modeling. In data flow modeling, how we are using graphs. So graphs means nodes and links. How we are using these nodes and links in data flow modeling. So the nodes are used to represent data objects in data flow modeling, and the links are used to represent transformations that occur to translate one data object into another. So the data objects here we are representing as nodes, and the translation existing between one data object to another data object, that we are representing the transformation or the translate, is we are representing here as links in data flow modeling. In this way, we are using graphs in data flow modeling. Then come to the fourth one, timing modeling. In timing modeling, how we are using means the nodes are represented as program objects, and the links are the sequential connections between those objects. So program objects are represented as nodes, and between the two different program objects, what is the sequential connection is exist, that connection will be called as links. So time modeling also using graph methods. So the nodes are represented as program objects, and the links are used as sequential connection between those objects. And the link weights are used to specify the required execution time as the program executes. So link weights represents the execution time of the program. So in this manner, graphs are used in timing modeling also. So by using graphs, these four different types of behavioral testing methods are also using the graph methods. So these are the four different behavioral testing methods. Then apart from these methods, black box testing have three important concepts are there. One is equivalence partitioning, and second one, boundary value analysis, and third one, orthogonal array testing. So these three concepts are also important points in black box testing. Then come to the first point, equivalence testing. So what is mean by equivalence testing? Equivalence partitioning in a black box testing method that divides the input domain of a program into classes of data from which test case can be derived. For example, so in equivalence partitioning in black box testing method, so what is this equivalence partitioning doing in black box testing is, it simply divides the input domain of a program. So what are the input domains we are providing to the program? Those input domains are divided into classes of data. So that input domain is purely divided into classes of data. By using the classes of data, we can derive test cases to test the programs. So this is the main usage of equivalence partitioning in black box testing. So simply what they are saying is, by using equivalence partitioning in black box testing, we are dividing the input domains of the programs into classes of data. By using these classes of data, we are deriving test cases to test your software. So that is the concept of equivalence partitioning. Then come to the second one, boundary value analysis. So what is this boundary value analysis? A greater number of errors occurs at the boundaries of the input domain rather than in the center. So most of the errors are occurred in the input domain environment, not in center of the program. So that's why what we want to do, it is for this reason that boundary value analysis has been developed as a testing technique. Boundary value analysis leads to a selection of test cases that exercise bounding values. That means, so most of the greater number of errors are occur in boundaries only, not in the center of the program. So to test that one, we developed a testing technique called boundary value analysis. So with the help of boundary value analysis, we lead to selecting some test cases to exercise bounding values. So with the help of these analysis, we can eradicate number of errors at the starting of the program itself. So this is the concept of boundary value analysis. That means what are the values in the input domain, we can test and we can remove the errors there itself only. So this is the concept of boundary value analysis. Then the third concept is orthogonal array testing. So what is meant by orthogonal array testing? If this testing can be applied to problems in which the input domain is relatively small but too large to accommodate exhaustive testings. So wherever we have an input domain is relatively very small but it plays most important place in the testing, in such an environment we can place orthogonal array testing. And orthogonal array testing method is particularly useful in finding region faults. That means based on in particular region, is there any problems are there, to find out that region, not overall program. In that program, a particular region may contain any faults or errors. To find out that region faults, orthogonal array testing is more useful. And an array category associated with faulty logic within a software component, this means the regional faults. So orthogonal array testing is mainly useful in finding region faults. Okay, this is the concept of orthogonal array testing, and this is the overall concepts of black box testing. So in black box testing, what are the points we need to remember means, what is mean by black box testing? It's also called as behavioral testing, and where at all we can use black box testing to find out the errors, and what's mean by graph-based testing methods, and what are the different number of behavioral testings are used graph-based in the four different types of transactional test modeling and finite state modeling, data flow modeling, and the last one, timing modeling. And three important points are there: equivalence partitioning, and second one, boundary value analysis, and the third point is orthogonal array testing. So these are all the concepts we are discussed in black box testing. Then today's our second concept is model based testing. What is meant by model based testing? Model based testing is shortly called as MBT, and it is also a black box testing technique that uses information contained in the requirement model as the basis for generation of test cases. So with the help of model based testing, we are generating test cases. To generate those test cases, we are using informations contained in requirement model. So for black box testing, model based testing is also used in black box testing to generate test cases. To generate those test cases, the information contained in the requirement model will act as the basic. So this is called model based testing. So model based technique requires 5 steps to construct or to generate any test case, to test any software or program. In model based testing, we want to follow these 5 steps. So in the first step is analyze an existing behavioral model for the software or create one. So whatever the behavioral model is existed for a software or any creating or created one, you want to analyze that model or software first. First you want to analyze the existing behavioral model of the software. First you want to analyze. Then second step is traverse the behavioral model and specify the inputs that will force the software to make the transition from one state to another state. For example, if you have any program, how the program will move from one state to another state only by providing any input to that one. Well, after getting the input only, process the data and it moves to another state. So otherwise, it may be simply in ideal state. So you want to traverse the behavioral model by specifying any input. So second point is traverse the behavioral model and specify the input that will force the software to make the transition from one state to another state. So first point is analyze, and second point, traverse the behavioral model by providing the input. Then third step is review the behavioral model and note the expected output as the software makes the transition from one state to another state. So in the second step, we have provided input. For that, what is the output it providing? So you must be review the behavioral model and note the expected output as the software makes the transition from one state to another state. So what is the input you have provided? For that input, you want to review what is the output, that means expected output your software is generating. And afterwards, the fourth step, you want to execute the test cases for that program. So once provide the general input and get the expected output, afterwards you want to execute the test cases, generate the test cases and execute the test cases for your program. Then in the fourth step, you want to compare the actual and the expected result that take corrective actions as required. That means, so final step is you want to compare the actual and expected results. That means actual result you may get from these two points, second point and third point, by giving input and getting output. This comes under actual, and by you, with the help of test cases, what is the result you are getting? It comes under expected result. Okay, so when comparing these two results, so we can find out whether you want to take any corrective actions are required. So this is the total testing method, that nothing but modern based testing method in black box testing concept. So this is nothing but model based testing method. So today we discussed two concepts. One is black box testing and second one is model based testing. It is also a black box testing technique. So based on these two concepts, I given some assignment questions. So these are those assignments questions.